Just following up on that question about the interior health, Vancouver Coastal Health used to have the second most cases, but there has been a steep decrease over the past month to the point now that Vancouver Coastal Health has been registering lower than interior health. Is there anything in particular that Vancouver Coastal Health is doing effectively, considering we're much more densely populated or anything like that?
Yeah, all communities are doing all kinds of things, and we had issues more recently where cases started to go up again in places like the downtown east side, so making sure we could bring second doses and first doses back to people and the opportunities to be immunized in those communities. Richmond was also an area where we had lower immunization, and focusing on working with that community has made a huge difference. I think it's the fact that we focused on getting access to vaccination for people who were working in areas where they couldn't work from home, and I know Vancouver Coastal did this very early on. Everything from grocery store workers to first responders to making sure that young people who work in the hospitality industry got access to vaccine, and that's been really, really effective. Where we have seen transmission in countries around the world, and I think about the UK and the rapid increase they've had in with the new, more transmissible virus circulating, it often is in young people, and we know that younger people have a lot more contacts with people in the same age group, and then we can get spillover into older people who are more at risk of being in hospital or having severe illness. So there was a lot of concerted effort, both in Fraser and in Vancouver Coastal, to make sure that we could get vaccine available to younger workers who need it to go into work and had those contacts, and I think they've been very, very successful. And I look at Whistler as well, and one of my colleagues who works in the immunization clinic up there, and I think they immunized 2,000 people in a day, and it is in for second doses for most of them. So taking that community approach and ensuring that there's access makes a big difference.
Craig, do you have a follow-up?
Yes, thanks. Also, over the past few months, a number of gyms have been listed amongst the businesses temporarily closed by health authorities due to COVID. I was just wondering, with high-intensity fitness starting up again, and now with immunizations and variants in the mix, is there anything that gym users should be wary or cautious of, or was there anything that those gyms that were closed down, was there anything that they were failing to do, or any common issues amongst them?
So there's a whole bunch of things. We had a lot of places that stayed open as long as we possibly could with the COVID safety plans in place. And I talked a little bit about this earlier, but we recognized that with the newer, more transmissible variants, we had less leeway, less wiggle room for safety. And it was those high intensity workouts, and some of them which were lifelines for people in a small enclosed area where the ventilation may not have been good, and it could spread so quickly. So we saw that in a lot of places. So for the most part, people had good safety plans, but the level of risk went up so dramatically when we had so much more transmission in the community and in younger people who may not have got that sick themselves, so felt it was still okay to go into the gym and have that workout. So there was many different reasons, and it can be quite specific to specific sites. But in general, when we had a lot of transmission in the community, those environments where you were closer together, where people were working hard, where there was a lot of virus in the air, meant that things were no longer safe in those environments, and it could transmit very easily. We're moving into a place where people are immunized, where we can put increased space, so it's not full on back into those crowded classes for sure. And we need to remember that we are still a little bit at risk, which means if you're not feeling well, you should not go. If you've been exposed to anybody, you should not be going. If there's people in your social circle that have COVID, then you need to be really careful and not go into those high-risk environments right now and get tested.